Okay, dear friend, once again, good evening. Now, let us start the session. In previous session, what I have explained, anyone? No one can. Am I? Yes, yes.
So communication cycle, elements of communication cycle.
Okay, very good. So in previous session and the as per your syllabus part A, I have explained employability skills, and under the employability skill, the unit one, that is communication skills. And in communication skills, I have explained what is communication and also the communication cycle, then objective of effective communication, and also the communication element. So today we will discuss about the method of communication. Okay? So, students, method of communication means we are using different channel, etc. So you might have used different method of communication in your daily life. There must be some method while playing with your friends, as showing gestures, giving indications, or waving, or maybe sometimes with drawing images, portrayal, or a sketch to depict a particular situation. Okay, so such different methods of communications. Okay, so you can earlier in syllabus just you see in the figure the types of communication. In fact, the communication, the types of communication based upon two things. One is based on communication channels, and another one is based on style and purpose. So the based on communication channel, the communication can be classified into two parts. One is non-verbal and verbal. Furthermore, verbal is classified in two parts, that is oral communication or written communication. Oral communications also classified in two parts, face-to-face communication or in distance communication. And on the other hand, based on a style and purpose, also communication is classified into two categories. One is formal and another one is informal. But in the latest syllabus, you can directly classify the method of communication, and that is verbal communication, non-verbal communication, and visual communication. So, dear student, today I am going to focus about verbal communication, non-verbal communication, and visual communication. Isn't it? So,
yes, sir.
Okay. Now, first of all, we will discuss about verbal communication. Okay. simply we can say it is the common method of communication that enables direct understanding and intact interpretation. Okay? That means,
yes, sir.
Once again, verbal communication is the common method of communication that enables direct understanding and intact interpretation. Or in other words, and the verbal communication of two types. One is oral or spoken communication, and another one is written communication. So simply oral communication, once again you see, the verbal communication is the use of language to transfer or share information through speaking or sign language, isn't it? So it is one of the most common types communication often used during presentations, video conferences, phone calls, meetings, and one-on-one conversations. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Once again, verbal communication is of two types. One is oral or spoken communication, and another one is written
communication.
Yes. So now what do you mean by oral communication? Oral communication, use of language to transfer or share information through a speaking or sign language. Okay. And where oral communication is used, or what's the area where oral communication or spoken communication is used? So during presentation, any, like right now the classes is going on, then the in video conference, while you making phone calls, meetings, and one-to-one conversations. Now just you see this figure and just tell me which type of communication this is.
Verbal speaking, so oral communication.
Yes, oral communication. And what you see in this picture?
Group conversation between students.
Yeah, group conversation between the or among the students, because there are four students. Okay. And now each and every student use the communication, oral communication. Okay. So now, what's the advantage of verbal communication? You see the picture and tell me the advantage of verbal communication.
Sir, we can interact much easily.
Yes, speak loudly.
It saves time.
Okay, or another one?
It is the good way to express the feelings and
you can share your feelings by using any other methods. Okay, like in non-verbal, you can also share your feelings. Okay, just a minute. I am telling you. The first one, it is a fast method of communication. If you have pen and paper, then you notate it down on the paper. Okay. The first advantage of verbal communication is It is a fast method of communication. The next one, it provides you to get the quick response. Okay? It provides you to get the quick response. Next one, it enables to understand the mood of the other person because the person is in front of you. Isn't it? Now, the next one, you can also say it looks more reliable than other conventional method of communication. In the verbal communication, the speaker and the listener may keep changing reply one after another as they communicate in real time. So these are the advantages of the verbal communication. Okay? Now, what are the disadvantages of verbal communication? Just you focus on this figure or picture and then you describe about advantage or disadvantage. So I think it fails to fill the gap of cultural differences between the sender and receiver if there is language barrier. Okay? That means first disadvantage is language barrier. The second one is the different languages spoken all over the world have different accent and uses different phrases, which causes confusion in the receiver's mind. Okay? So, as there is not much of time in verbal communication, the delivery may be misinterpreted if the receiver does not understand instantly. So, main focus for the language barrier. Okay, now any question, any confusion regarding oral communication?
No, sir.
Okay, so you understand clearly? Yeah.
Sir, please repeat disadvantages again.
Okay, right now I provide the slide for you. Okay. Once again, the main thing is, okay, language barrier. Language barrier means what? It fails to fill the gap of cultural difference between the sender and receiver, okay, due to the language barrier. Because the different languages spoken all over the world have different accents and uses different phrases, which causes confusion in the receiver's mind. Right. So, in verbal communication, what happened? As there is not much of time, because this one is the direct communication, so the delivery may be misinterpreted due to the confusion. So, if the receiver does not understand instantly, that is why language must be compatible. Isn't it? Now, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, move to the next one is the written communication. Okay. So now, written communication is the act of writing, typing, or printing symbols like letters and numbers to convey information. Okay. And so it provides a record of information or reference. Writing is commonly used to share information through books, pamphlets, blogs, letters, memos, emails, SMS, and more. emails and chats are a common form of written communication in the workplace or in IT industry. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, oral communication means simply, in one line answer, when communication is established through telephone conversation, face-to-face talking, okay, etc. are example of oral or spoken communication. And written communication means when communication is made using written or typed messages in the form of an email, SMS, okay, or by using any other format, including photos, videos, music, etc. Okay, then it is known as written communication. In classroom, you use both communication, written communication as well as oral communication. Now, let us just see the picture. Just you see and tell me which type of communication, and tell me about one or two sentences about the picture.
This is written communication.
Okay, what the picture says? That means there are several tools like pen, paper, copy, etc. are used for written communication. Okay. And I think most of the students sitting inside the classroom, and they perform the classwork by utilizing written communication. So once again, right now you have learned about the verbal communication, and verbal communication of two types, oral communication and written communication.
Written communication.
Okay. Now move to the next. Now the another communication method is non-verbal communication. Student, as we know, all living things communicate. The animal communicate through different types of sound, smell, signs, etc. In a non-verbal communication, words are not used to communicate, as sender's message is conveyed without using words, right? Non-verbal communication includes symbols, gestures, eye contact, handshake, facial expressions, body language, etc. These are the means of non-verbal communication, isn't it? So, we can say, on the other hand, non-verbal communication is the use of body language, gesture, and facial expression to convey information to others, right? It can be intentional or unintentional. And the main thing, non-verbal communication is helpful when trying to understand others' thoughts and feelings. Okay? That means to understand other person's thoughts and feelings, then non-verbal communication is very helpful. Now, once again, you see the picture. And then feel about the non-verbal communication. What you see in the picture? No one can.
That they are using non-verbal communication to communicate.
Okay, but that is written already, and I know you have learned. You define what is non-verbal communication. You just see the picture, okay? And this, and then say something about the picture. What's the expression of this picture?
The students are using sign languages to communicate.
Yes, the students are within the classroom, and the students cannot use any words for communication. Okay, they have different gesture and body language. Okay, and also they have facial expression and convey information to others, and also using different signs. Okay, different signs. So such type of communication is called non-verbal communication. Okay, once again, in non-verbal communication, how you communicate? That means any sender, any message is conveyed without using words. Okay? Just what non-verbal communication include? Any symbols, gestures, eye contact, okay? Handshake, facial expression, etc. Exclamatory. Now move to the next. Now the next one is visual communication. Now what do you mean by visual communication? Visual communication, in fact, is another method in which ideas are conveyed in the visual form, okay, which can be seen in the form of image or picture. In visual communication, there is no use of language, isn't it? It is also considered as the oldest form of communication. So, in other words, we can say visual communication is the act of using photographs, videos, art, drawings, sketches, charts, and graphs to convey information. These are the tools used for visual communication. Visuals are often used as an aid during presentation to provide helpful context alongside written and or verbal communication. Since people have different learning styles, visual communication might be more helpful for some to consume ideas and information. Student, you use visual communication or not?
Yes, sir, we use.
Where?
At here only.
In the school.
sir, where on?
In school premises, you use visual communication or not? Say yes or no. Don't be shy. Okay. Now, just let us see this picture. Now, you use such type of communication in school or not?
Yes, sir.
A smart classes, yes, is in our school. So this is an example of visual communication. Okay. Yes, now you just look another picture. And now imagine in this communication what happened. Just ideas are conveyed in each and everything. Is conveyed in visual form. Okay? Mean it can be seen in the form of image or picture, like emergency exit. Okay? Suppose sometimes danger. Then such type of communication is called visual communication. Okay? So, today in this session, what you have learned? You have learned about method of communication, and there are three types of communication: verbal communication, non-verbal communication, and visual communication. Furthermore, verbal communication of two types, one is oral communication and another one is written communication. And we have also discussed about the advantage and disadvantage of verbal communication. Okay, so in next session, we will discuss about the next concept as per your syllabus. Now, any question to be asked? No more.